Hello, I am Neil Jain from QCFinance.in. The topic is Calculus Operations with MATLAB. The digital computer operates on the numerical basis, that is addition, subtraction, etc. But true differentiation and integration, that is the calculus operations, cannot be achieved exactly with these processes. So, there are two ways that differentiation and integration can be achieved on a practical level with MATLAB software. Now, the two types of operations. First, MATLAB can be viewed as a comprehensive lookup table in that numerous derivatives and integrals as character strings can be manipulated with software. Okay. Now, the symbolic math toolbox. It permits you the exact formula for the derivatives and integration to be extracted, manipulated and plotted. The second way is MATLAB can be used for calculus. The second way is MATLAB can be used for calculus with numerical approximations to differentiation and integration. Now, while such approximations are not exact, they can be used to provide extremely closer approximations for derivatives and integrals. So, even when closed form solutions are impossible in this. Now, coming towards the symbolic variables. For example, if you want to make X and A symbolic, then the command will be SYMS for symbols, X space A. Or alternatively, you can also use the apostrophes for this. Now, for the differentiation, the command is DIFF, div and bracket. The bracket you have to write the function. And all the variables should have been established as symbolic variables. Or the function should be enclosed by the apostrophes. Now, coming towards the example, this is a very easy example and we will see it in different ways. Such as I am having a function y that is equal to 4x to the power 5. I want the derivative of the function y. Then what the command I will tell. The first way is first write SYMSX. We have just seen this, why we have to write this, because it is a variable and I have to define it. Now we are defining the function y, that is 4 into x to the power 5. You have to write it symbolically in the MATLAB. Then for the derivative of y, you have to write y prime equal to diff of y. Y is a function, therefore in the bracket of the differentiation command, that is diff, you have to write the function of which you have to find the derivative. Here we are using y. And after writing this command, you will get your derivative, that is 20x to the power 4. Now, second approach can be that you do not need to define y. You can direct use the function y prime equal to diff and the function of y in respect to x, that is 4x to the power 5. But in this case, you have to keep in mind that if you will direct give this command, then see, you will get an error like this because you have not defined the x. So, first you have to define the x and then you can use this. See, in this way, I have first defined the variable x and then I have gave this command. Okay, and I have got the output of this. Now, the third approach can be if you do not want to define the variable x in a separate command, then simply use the apostrophes this while defining the y, then also you can get the output. Now, the conclusion from the second and third step is we can get the third approach direct in the one step. That is in the one command. See, direct define the y prime equal to diff. Here we write the y simply put instead of y and defining the x independently. You can define diff in bracket apostrophe and the y function. Then also you can get the answer. Now along with that, I am also trying a different command, that is y equal to diff of 4 into x to the power 5. If I am giving this command, then I am getting the output. Here you can see 20x to the power 4, but along with a warning. What is the warning? The method, character or diff will be removed in a future release. So you have to take care of it. Use sim or diff instead. For example, diff of sim of x to the power square after removal will return double. Okay, so today the MATLAB will run this command, but in future it may happen that it will not run. So you have to define x as sim. Now coming towards the use of ez plot, it is nothing but a function used for plotting the graph of a function with respect to the variable whichever we use. The simplest form is ez plot of y, that y is a function, but in this the domain will be minus 2 pi to pi if you will not define the range any other than this. Now for example, if you want to change the range from minus pi to 2 pi to any another range, then you have to define it. For example, ez plot y comma minus 1 to 1, here the range I have changed from minus 1 to 1. Okay, now MATLAB also have a command help. You can use this command help and get the detail of the function and the commands. For example, about ez plot, if I want to know more, then I have to just type help ez plot and it will give me the detail about it. See, you can get the detail and you can use it more accurately. Now let's try the ez plot. Suppose I am taking ez plot of y prime, then see, I'll get this plot. Okay, and if I change the range from minus 1 to 1, then I'll get the plot ranging from minus 1 to 1. Okay, so this was about ez plot. These are the two plots that you will get. Now coming towards the integration, that let's say symbolic integration here. Now the command is int and bracket with a function to be integrated, and all the variables should be established as symbolic variables as we have done in the differentiation, that is SYMS, or the function should be enclosed by apostrophes. Now there are two types, that is indefinite and definite integral. For this you are having different commands. Now here is example for how to integrate the function z. Suppose I am having a function z and I want its integration, then z is equal to y integration and y is equal to x square e ki power x. So you have to start from the basic, that is x square into e to the power x. You have to define first the variable x. I have defined it, seems x. Then you have to define the function y, that is x to the power 2 into e of x. Your e to the power x is written as exp of x in the MATLAB. Okay, now after that you have to define z. How? Z is equal to int of y, and after giving this command you will get the output. Now we are also given here that z of 0 is 0, but the function obtained has a value of 2 at x equal to 0. That is, if you will put the value of x 0, then the value of z will be 2. So for obtaining x of 0 equal to 0, we have to give a command z equal to z minus 2, and now the z will become this expression. Now the plots of one that I this the plot of x and y, and this is the plot of z with respect to x. Now numerical differentiation, generally we see that the numerical differentiation can be more errors than compared to the integration, because it has a nature of sudden changes in differentiation. So we approach it by using del function, that is dy by dx is approximated as del y by del x. Now here are the commands for numerical data. We are assuming that x and y have been defined at n plus 1 points, and a vector u with n points can be defined using x and y as, you can use u1 equal to y2 minus y1. These are on the points. Okay, u1, 2, these are all the points that we are taking. Similarly, you can use for u2, u3, and in general, you can get a formula by it, that is u of n will be equal to y of y at n plus 1 point minus y at nth point. Now, for u, we have a command u equal to def of y using the above relations that we have seen. Now, for approximating it, we have y prime equal to def of y upon del of x. That we have seen del y by del x, we are putting it here. Now, because x and y have one more point than the y prime, they can be adjusted as x equal to x from 1 to n point and y also from 1 to n point. And then we can plot the. Now, taking examples, we have a function y that is equal to sine of x, and we have to determine the numerical derivative of it based on 11 points in one cycle. Now, for this example, the program will be, first of all, we have to define the x. For defining the x, we have here 11 points, so the range will be from 0 to 11, and we have to complete it in one cycle. So the we have used 2 pi. One cycle is equal to 2 pi. Okay, now, the another step will be defining the function y. Y is simply sine of x, so we can define it easily. Now, for del x and y prime, del x will be 2 pi by 10, and y prime will be differentiation of y by del x. The now we can define the x points, that is 1 to 10. And then we can plot it. So this is the plot of the function. Now, if the same example is asked on the 101 points in one cycle, then the changes will only at some points. The first change will be on the defining x. Here we have to define the x from 0 to 101 point. As we have to define only one cycle, so we are using 2 pi only. So y same, del x also, 2 pi by 100 instead of 10. Then we have defined the y prime, del y by del x. X again ranges from 0.1 to 100. And same, we have plotted it. See, here this is the plot of the function on 101 points. Now coming towards the numerical integration, two types are there for numerical integration, zero order and first order. First order is also known as trapezoidal rule. Okay. Now we are assuming the vectors x and y that have each been defined at n points. Now, previously as we have defined the u function for differentiation, here we are defining the z function for integration, for zero order integration. Here we are having the formula for zero order, that is x z1 is equal to y1 into del x. Similarly, z2 z1 plus y2 of del x. If you want to open it, you can open, put the value of z1, then the formula will become y1 plus y2 into directs. Similarly, the general formula will become z of zk equal to z of k minus 1 plus z at yk del of x, which is simply a summation of yn. Now there are two commands for zero order integration, that is sum and cumsum. Okay, for example, area equal to del x into sum of y and z equal to del x into cumsum of y. You can use it different places. Now coming towards the first order integration. For the first order integration, we have the following formulas, and by this formula, the general formula come out to be z at k equal to z at k minus 1 plus y at k minus 1 plus y at k by 2 into del x. You have to use it directly. Now similarly, in the first order MATLAB also we have two commands, traps and cum traps. Now we are determining exact area A for the following integral. The example is, let A equal to 4x cube, integration from 0 to 2 with respect to x. If we will solve it normally, then we will get the answer 16. Now taking the same example but determining the approximate area A1 with zero order integration and taking the step size of 0.05. This step size is nothing but the del x size. Okay, so for this program will be, first we have to define the del x size, that is del x equal to 0.505, sorry. Then we are defining the x in the preview. Now in the function given to us, the x range is from 0 to 2. So here we are defining the x range from 0, difference is del x and maximum is 2. Defining the y is 4x cube. So simply defining it in the terms of MATLAB, 4 into x dot cube. Now the function area A1, for integration we have to give the command A1 equal to del x into sum of y. As we are using the zero order integration, so we are using sum of y, and you will get the answer 16.81, that is approximately equal to 16. Now if we find out the integration of the same function but using the first order integration, that then the answer will be approximately different. Such as, I have used the same function and parameter, I have defined del x 0.05 only, x is also the same, y is also the same, 4x cube, but I have defined in the area as del x into traps of y. Traps is used for first order integration. Then the output is coming 16.01, which differs from the zero order integration output, that was 16.81. So here some of the difference come between the zero order and first order integration. Now another example, determining the exact running integral for the following function, that is z equal to sine of x dx from 0 to x. Simply solving this example, we get the answer 1 minus cos of x. Now for the same function, we determine the first order approximation having 100 points per cycle. The per cycle means we are to take 2 pi and we have to plot the function. So first of all, we have to define del x as it is of first cycle. So 2 pi and 100 points, therefore upon 100. Now x will be from 0 to 2 pi, difference is del x, so 0 colon del x colon 2 pi. Now the y, now for defining the z, that is integral of function, I am taking that function, that is sine of x as y. So I am defining y equal to sine of x, and then I will define z 1 for the integration of z, that will del x into cum traps of y, cum traps because I am using the first order integration, and then I am plotting the function. So this is the plot of the function. Now coming towards the next example. The example is such as, a test is performed on a mechanical part and the acceleration versus time is measured and shown on the next slide, that is this. This is the acceleration versus time data. Okay. Now we have to use the MATLAB to determine and plot the velocity and displacement as a function of time. So the given data with us is time and acceleration. These are the data, time 0, 2.9 and acceleration points. Now let's see the command for this example. First of all, we have to define the del t. Okay. Now for defining the del t, we have to see the difference. Here I am seeing the time. The time difference is 0.1. You can see between the points, the difference is 0.1. So here I am defining del t equal to 0.1. Now the second step is defining the t. Let's see the range of t. Here the t is starting from 0 and ending to 2. So I am defining t as starting point 0 colon difference del t, that is 0.1 colon, and ending is 2. Now for defining the acceleration, you have to write all the 21 values of a, because they are having no common separation and no common formula that we can use here. So you have to write all the values. Data 0, 9.05, this line, and till 27.07. Now we know that the velocity is nothing but the integration of acceleration. So simply give the command for integration of acceleration and displacement. And for the displacement, it is integration of velocity. So I am giving the command for that and simply plotting all the values, all the functions. Now the output will be this: acceleration, velocity and displacement all are plotted. Thank you.